I'm Smile for me, by far my always best player, but yeah, look, gives them a sneaky chance with, you know, probably 20 minutes to go.
Yep, 17 points, and Traralgon have assumed control of this match in the first 15 minutes, and despite some peaks and troughs of Maui, they still have a handy lead, but it's not a match-winning lead. As Adrian Burgill has alluded to, Maui very much alive. Ball back in the centre, James van der Warden. Contest the ball, Maui again, get the breakthrough boarding, right half forward flank, even deeper than that, at ground level though, Traralgon have possession. they settle, they kick to a contest towards the halfback flank, and it's going to be Ambler that takes the mark. Left halfback flank. Goes along the line, the lead's on. Nicely done, Willerton wearing the six. Plays onto the corridor. Good contest there, falls to the front of the pack. Who's got the numbers? Mowie at the moment, they clear the area. The next goal could be important for them. Two straight kicks if they can convert the next rush forward. Wood runs 20, kicks to the top of the square. One-on-one contest, nice mark. Scots led to the ball by Matthews, who scored the side's last goal. And now, from 25 metres out, on the slightest of angles, breathes life into this game for his Lion side.
Baldy off after those last two clearances and inside 50, so he's definitely getting his hand on the ball. This is such an important kick.
Okay. So Matthews it is. His first goal just moments ago. Can he go back to back? Off the boot, looks pretty neat. Slips as he kicks, but it's enough. Straight through the middle, and all of a sudden, the Moe players, the Moe supporters, the Moe bench has come alive.
The last four inside 50s there to Moe, and they're definitely on top here. The next 2 or 3 minutes here, this clearance is really, really, really important. So back in the game, I reckon Traralgon, you know, with only those two rotations, might be feeling it a little bit.
The game very much alive. Traralgon 9-13, Moe 8-8. 11 points.
Are you going to get out there alive, Bobby?
I don't think so. 15 points the margin. 15 minutes the margin. And we've got a game on, haven't we? 11 points difference, 15 minutes to go.
And free kick straight out of the middle going for Alvin.
That's what they need.
No idea what it's for. I'm sure it was there, and the umpire said the ruckman can take it. He just handballed it back to the bloke who had it anyway. He kicks it up and down the chimney. It's going to land at centre-half forward. The big boys fly. No one able to complete the grab. Ball on the deck to be won. Spits out far side. Traralgon with the ball in front of him. One-on-one forward of the
downfield.
And the umpire again has inserted himself into the game by the looks of things, Bobby. And a free kick from umpire Hatwearer goes down the field, and Traralgon now get the chance to settle. They lead 67-56, 12 minutes gone. Moe's kicked the last couple, and this will just take a little bit of oxygen out of their balloon, I'd suggest.
Yeah. So two mistakes, one in the centre bounce and one free kick downfield.
I think Moe had too many in the centre clearance here in the centre bounce.
Pretty basic stuff, isn't it?
Joseph Coe should be furious.
So hard up against the boundary line, far side. Distance will not be an issue. Angle pretty tight. The third boys behind the goal will tell us the story the moment it comes off the boot, I suspect. Kick on its way. Not enough fence banging for the Traralgon boys' liking. Earlier, minus four on the scoreboard. That sees Traralgon move on to 9-14-68. 8-8-56, two straight kicks in it. There's the fence banging. Van Dyke can do the kicking again. Surely he goes long this time after the success he had last time. And of course he does exactly the opposite, the kick to the pocket where Bryce Collins takes a mark.
Well, this box reminds me of the times we used to go to the picture theatre at the moment. The window's starting to steam up as Moe also starting to steam up and go through Baldy. Half-board flank, they've got the run of the ball. Can Balfour get a favourable bounce? He can. Feeds it off to another young star in Callum Nash. Goes short. Danaher on the end of it. Stops, pops, goes inboard. Nicely done. Matthews, it's a free kick. It's going to go Moe's way.
Danaher.
And Danaher's going to get the free kick. This will test that left hamstring. Side trails by two straight kicks. He hands balls off just very quickly. Nicely done. Goal. Harry Pepper. Kick one of the first. One of the last. And all of a sudden, Burke win a game.
Harry Pepper kicked the first goal of the game. And
yes.
Actually hasn't been seen all day. So, obviously, I think they still see Danaher very sore. So, it's a good point to get the scoreboard.
It's almost unbelievable he's out there, isn't it? Like, he dead set looks like he couldn't break into a gallop, yet he's been influential in two goals in this last quarter. So I guess if you can do no more damage to it, you may as well stay out there and do your thing for the side, and that's exactly what he's done. Next centre clearance, absolutely crucial here. Let's have a look for the Traralgon midfield. They've got to go with their A grade, so that'll be Ambler in the middle for sure, you would suspect. Willett will probably push up as well.
The Oakleys.
And the Oakleys or Daltrey making up the numbers in there as well.
They're not hearing anything.
And it's the A-grade ruckman in today, Lachlan McGrath, up against Vanna Warden. This tap absolutely crucial. He'll look for Baldy. Tap goes down. Ruckman falls on it. The other ruckman falls on him, and the umpire comes in and tosses it up.
See, I don't like the way Vanna Warden fell then, but no, he's got up. He's okay and ready to go. this ruck. For Traralgon, centre of Terry Hunter Oval. 50-50, boardy. Expecting to have an impact now that the pressure's on. Quick kick around the body from rock towards half forward flank. Umpire says no mark and calls to take control.
You really feel the tension out there now, Bobby, can't you? It's gone pretty quiet. We all know the game's on.
15 minutes, final quarter. Traralgon have been in control, but now only lead by the straight kick. Coming in nicely was Brown. Couldn't take the ball. Molly go forward, inside 50. Big punch forward by Herrigan. Can he find a teammate? He can. Can't keep control, though. Nicely done. Molly continually applying the pressure, but a quick kick forward by Eden. Can only find the boundary. It's not a bad result. It now becomes a 50-50 contest inside forward 50.
Well, Albert's starting, struggling to get their hands on the ball here, especially in the midfield.
Pick a kid here, Boots. Who do they go to? Do they go to Masters? Do they go to Nash?
I'll go to Masters all night.
Yep. Matthews in the goal square. All three of the kids out there when the game's out of their one. A lot of faith being shown in them by the coach. Ball tossed in 20 metres around for the Mowie goal. They'll trail by 6 points. Banner Wooden gets a tap. It goes down to Masters. He gets a little handball over there to the teammate. Sim snap on goal goes wide and through for a minor score. But what that does, it means if they kick another goal, they actually hit the front. So things are really tightening up here. 16 minutes play, last quarter.
We've had the last five inside 50s here, Mowie.
And Sim, that's normally bread and butter for him. No pressure. Had to kick around the body. As Herrigan now brings the ball back into play, draws the player over the top to Stoltz. That left leg comes grandstand side. But there's not as much method in the way they get out of the defense as there has been in the first three quarters, and Van Dyke takes the easiest of marks. So Scott Van Dyke plays on. Hamilton tries to close him down. Kicks to the top of the square. Important contest, no. Equal to the task. Reckon it could be Membry, is it?
Yeah.
Mitch Membry takes the mark, last line of defense. So they definitely need the next score, Traralgon. As Moe have got themselves into this game. Relentless they've been in their ability to claw back in. They go short to Traralgon. Keep control. Ambler. Play onto the call. Didn't go the required distance. And now, outer side of the ground. Towards the outer side wing. Moe, good mark.
Coach.
And Kelty plays on through the corridor. There's some space to move, but it's going to be a big contest right now. Masters fights hard. He's taken, and the umpire will take control.
I like the coach. Take it on. Go through the middle. Kick it to the kid. Give him a chance. Use his wheels. Ball up. Middle of the ground. 17 and a half gone. Traralgon lead by just 5 points after having the game seemingly wrapped up a quarter ago. Traralgon win the stoppage. Flick the ball out far side. D'Angelo leads in the chase. Ball turned over. Mowie through Masters. Flick the ball forward again. Hot contest there. Big transition there. Mowie win the footy. Looks for Baldy, can't quite get that far. Mowie marked across half forward. Kick impacted by the tackle. Probably should have gone back and had his kick rather than played on. And the umpire will come in and toss this one up 60 metres out. We're 60 metres out from the Mowie goal. They probably haven't led since about the 4 minute mark in the first quarter. They've trailed by as much as 5 goals. Here they are, 5 points behind when the game's on the line.
So right half forward flank, Mowie into attack, as Scotty B's described for you. Falls to ground level, Sim quick kick, centre half forward, top of the square. Ground level, Mowie, just about went with the ball, couldn't. Brown, Brent at bottom of the pack, fights hard to kick the ball in the area, and does so. 18 and a half minutes gone, Traralgon by 5 points.
Mowie one-on-one behind the footy, they haven't got a loose bloke back there, which means Traralgon can't have a loosey down there, so Hurrigan's got to be on someone. And the big boys fly in the ruck. Ball hits the deck. Traralgon through hands. D'Angelo flicks it over the top. Finds a little bit of space. Now they get it out to Cooper Brown, who's got some jets. He flicks a handball further afield. They balance up here across the space. As Halliburton kicks the space over the top. Hamilton marks. Springs to his feet. Reels around the corner. 2-on-1. Forward to the footy. The press fly. 50-50 for the Bowie defenders. They kill the contest. But Traralgon moved the ball from one end of the ground to the other. 19 minutes gone. What do you say, Bert?
That's probably the first time this quarter they've actually tried and got that run back. They would have had in the first quarter when they were looked very dangerous and they were scoring.
Yeah, very hard to find space for the home side at the moment. As you called earlier, Mowie have closed everything down. Made it a one-on-one contest in most areas. And that's what we've got right now. The ball will be thrown back in just metres from Traralgon's goals. They lead by just 5 points. Could this be their chance? Laprise's attempt to smother. Doesn't work. Membry gets a bounce, he gets tackled as well. Play on for the call. Mowie go forward. and they get it out of the centre-half back, they can. Nice, strong work, but coming in was... he's taken the ball at all by Baldy. No surprise there. And the umpire will ball this one up. Nearly 20 minutes gone. Final quarter. Traralgon leading by 5 points, but after being in control there, just hanging on now. Next score, obviously crucial, as a third player comes off Traralgon, injured. Which means that Wimbledon comes on, he's had a freshen up, and his speed is much needed. He could be the difference.
I think that might be the other Hamilton that came off after that marking contest. Ball in the middle of the ground, Van der Warden gets a tap out the back. Only goes as far though as Pepper, who's come right up the ground, getting himself involved in the game. Traralgon with two players loose off the footy. And it might have been Connor Scandrick coming off, thanks Bergs, rather than Hamilton. So ball up still in the middle of the ground. Van der Warden does well to hold his space. Murray, however, get the handball into that first bit of space. Can't quite get the one into the second bit of space, but they go back in again. Third time, fourth time. Big efforts here required from all and sundry. D'Angelo keeps it in front of him. Willington puts the handball up. Really good play there across the half-forward line by McMahon. He dumps the ball into the forward 50 for Traralgon. Murray resolute in defence, but they just need to get through the possession. And a big tackle laid there, and we'll see things stop.
As much as the momentum has been with Moe, you feel as though it's starting to swing back to Traralgon.
They're in hands on the ball.
Evening up the contest at the moment. Right half forward flank, grandstand side. In front of a healthy crowd tonight. It's the final game of round two. The ball with Moe at the moment. The pressure's been put right here. Traralgon's flank. 5 points to margin. The right half forward flank. The ball will be sent forward.
Take it on.
Into the danger zone as Amblin. In fact, it's not. Oh, it's a free kick. It's going to go Traralgon's way. Absolutely risky free kick to be paid. And it would have to be quite for it to be paid. Just 20 metres out and throw the goals. And at three occasions in this final quarter, Bergs, that free kicks have been paid that have cost money.
Is it Wilton?
I haven't held themselves with some really silly free kicks.
He's got to kick it.
So Wilton,
I'll bet you don't think.
Wilton with his hands on the footy on a 45 degree angle. Opportunity to make this a two-kick game. Inside lead by 5 points. He's 35, 40 metres out. He's been fantastic in front of goal. He's been fantastic all over the ground. This for a chance to put a little bit of breathing space on the scoreboard. He's throwing an 11-point lead.
I've never seen this thing before, but he's been very, very impressive in my life.
Sorry about Ben's car, and it was very busy. Today he becomes the highest goal scorer on the ground with that third goal.
No,
gives his side margin back to 11 points. They're not home, but they can see the finish line. 22 and a half minutes gone, final quarter.
Wood back on the ground and straight into the middle here for Murray. Last roll of the dice, stuff you'd expect. Masters in there with him. Baldy in there with him. Mixing youth and enthusiasm. And they've done it again. They've given away a five-person in the middle.
It's twice
free kick. Twice in the last 5 minutes, and the game is going to be decided by under a few kicks as criminal. As Traralgon thumped the ball in the Lopez direction. Into the forward 50 a go. Ball sits on a 10. No one able to take it at ground level. One handball too many, perhaps. They pile in on top. Moe just keen to keep the ball alive, keep it moving in their direction, and Traralgon equally is keen to sit on it and stop play, and they do exactly that, 50 metres out directly in front of their goal. And we've played nearly 23 and a half minutes. Traralgon lead by 11 points, and Moe continuing to shoot themselves in the foot.
So Moe have added 5 goals, 1 in this quarter, and Traralgon 2 goals, 2, and they're inside their forward 50, 45 metres from goals, kicking the rotor radio, the Loy Yang end of Terry Hunter Oval. Ball thrown up. Van der Warden gets a tapper. Might have been Lopraise, in fact, that contested that run. Comes out the back. Oh, you've got the numbers. They need to get the ball out of the area, but they're finding it hard to do so as the intensity's being picked up on this home side. They've found some room to wiggle, and they do just that. Play on quickly. That's the call. Take a risk. They need to do that. Also, Wood takes the mark. Plays on. He runs fast. He kicks long. It's a two-on-one contest, and the two favour the home side, Traralgon and Dunbar. In fact, grabs the ball on his left leg, composure, and answers the call with a beautifully left kick towards the left pocket. They're in no rush, Traralgon. They find James Van der Warden over the outer side of the ground. 24 and a half minutes gone now.
taking all the jet out of the donut, all the oxygen out of the balloon here, Traralgon. They just trip the ball forward.
Yeah.
Mark taking far side of the ground, and they'll just slow things down. Murray got to go one-on-one, make every possession a contest. Because Traralgon have got everything in their advantage at the moment. They kick the ball long down the line. A mark or a boundary line is a great result for Traralgon, and they get the mark.
Over the top.
They get the mark through Hamilton. He's two kicks from goal, so he plays on quickly, gets the ball forward to a one-on-two. You suspect the two would win, and they do. And Murray now just got to go off to the races every time they get the footy. So they play on straight away and switch. And they switch heavily, and they come broadcast side. Mark taken out here by Thomas Blackshaw, a long way from home. A little lead comes on, but he goes out and goes over the back. Look nicely.
Collins.
Collins has got three blokes in front of him wearing Terrell with the two blokes in Murray jumpers. So he goes top of the 50, squares it right up. Ball sits beautifully. Pops up into the hands there of Sim. Sim goes thump. And he goes out of bounds on the full. And that might have been the last roll of the dice, Poppy. We were 25 and a half gone at 74 plays 63. Traralgon lead and possess the footy.
Yeah, that's on the Harvey Norman Computers Gippsland scoreboard. Murray with two opponents, one of them Traralgon, the other time. And time's closing in quickly. Traralgon with the ball, left back pocket. Van Award's the outer side of the ground. It'll be just an aerial contest of Van Warden. Flew high, but at ground level, Murray with the numbers, inside forward 50 again. Nice tackle, play on the call. Kick from the pound! Don't tell me they're gone! They're gone! And the margin just 5 points again, with only a moment to go or two, maybe.
So we've got 3 minutes on the clock, Bobby.
3 minutes on the clock, one kick the difference, and all of a sudden, the game's alive.
I think that might be Thomas Matthews again. I think. So he's done really well this quarter. He's gone down forward. The young fellow who's on Gippsland Powers list and bottom age thirds player. So got a bit of talent, the young fella.
He has too. Tom Matthews, very militant-like in the way he plays, and both players have got three goals. But for Tommy Matthews, all three of his have come in this final quarter.
Very important clearance here.
So back in the middle we go. It'll be McGrath up against Daniel Warden.
Under 3 minutes to play.
5 points in at Traralgon lead.
It's bloody working, that's what the problem is.
McGrath tries to spike it forward. They win the ball at ground level, pump it into the forward 50, but down there Dunbar, who's set up behind the plate beautifully, and he wins the footy and kicks up to the half forward line. Contest brings the ball to ground, and Traralgon can do well to hold it in. What do you got for us, Burns?
Just quickly, boys, they rolled one behind the ball there, which was Dunbar, and he's the one that got that kick from that clearance. Very well coached by Traralgon.
Yeah, he's unassuming, his coach. New coach at Traralgon.
Very well spotted by you too, Burks.
Yeah, well done to Troy Hamilton.
Thanks, mate.
There's Van Warden with the ball over the outer side of the ground. They just not sure whether they've got a play for a situation like this when there's moments to go and there's a goal of the difference, but we're going to find out, aren't we? There's a Traralgon. Nicely done. D'Angelo over the top. They go forward to Traralgon. Next goal for them wins it. I reckon next goal wins the game. Full stop. Kelty, defensive 50, takes it, composed. Can he find a teammate? He can. Oh, probably what maybe he should have taken, a push in the back to the call. So just short of right half-back flank, Murray with the ball moving on quickly. It's all or nothing as they kick towards the corridors. They've given that one up. And Jurgen will be no rush to get rid of this ball, and he's not. Kim's ground keeps possession. Hamilton, they just need to burn this clock. Mind you, if there's a turnover, they might be burning their own time if they give up the lead.
So Skolts with the ball now across the half-back line. He goes directly backwards. And this is the target. The wheels come in. The tackle gets made. The handball mistakes. Ball sits on his head. Danaher picks it up. Flicks the handball forward. Masters grabs it. No, it's not Masters. Thomas, he grabs it. He's tackled.
Matthews.
Matthews even. First name Thomas. Surname Matthews. We're that close. I saw him by his first name.
Shouldn't be long to go here, boys.
Five points in it.
I'll go minute 40.
100 seconds to go, 5 points in a ball in the Murray forward 50. Van Warden does well to get a fist on it, clears it into a little bit of space. D'Angelo gets a half kick, comes out towards the boundary line. Eaton keeps it in, Masters flipped high. Makepeace can't take it cleanly and accidentally on purpose rushed over the boundary line. They're a really clever play by Lucas Traponi. They want to throw Albin's best.
Roughly a minute 24 left, folks.
A minute 24.
They've got 80 metres from goal, Poppy. You're going to call us home here for a Traralgon win, or are we going to pinch it?
I reckon I need your help too with a minute 24 to go, but 5 points the margin. Traralgon on the Harvey Norman Computers Gippsland scoreboard up by 5 points. Bowie into attack, set play, out the back they go, but they find a teammate they can't. Dunbar again, bottom of the pack, taken ball. No opportunity, and the umpire will take this one up. In fact, wasn't Dunbar for Traralgon. It was Tate Marsh. 450, free kick pay. Who's going to go?
He's going to re-toss it.
All right. So inside 450 for Moe. Banner Warden needs to get hand the ball. He doesn't. Good contest. D'Angelo goes for the safety of the boundary. A grand level, good pace. Free kick's going to be paid.
Moe got the ball in their hands. 80 metres from goal. Kick comes in from goals. Top of the square, John. Fisted away. Taken at ground level there by Sim. He's wrapped up in a tackle. Free kick. Kicks are dropping the through.
No,
goes to Alvin's way.
Hold
up. Sit up, listen to the siren sounds if they can. Every single player in one half of the ground, maybe one third of the ground, and Traralgon are going to hold onto the footy.
Well, Breeze has to push kick it. Well, Breeze should be pushing up the ground.
And when the umpire says he's going to kick it as long as he can,
wrong place.
He's come inboard a little bit, open the game up.
Wrong place.
Ball at ground level, ball pops out the back. Moe with the hand on the true rock. He's tackled. Can't be willing to go. Less than 30 seconds, I'm going to say.
39 seconds to go.
39 seconds. Last week they lost by 5. At the moment they lead by 5 to Traralgon. Half-court flank, Moe into attack.
So, most important clearance of the night here. Looks for Baldy to get his hands on it for Moe. Ball hits it there. Traralgon pile on top of themselves. Clever play.
33.
Clever play, 33 seconds to go. Bird's watching the clock like he's on double time on a Sunday.
There's a bit of space here inside this huddle.
Hack forward there by Matthews, start by Wood. Can't get it clear, stacks on the middle.
Yeah, hold
it. And that should do it. They play smart from here. The Traralgon defenders spread. And the kick can go sideways.
Just like control the footing.
And they
can
kill the clock.
Well, they tried to
kill the clock before. The final match of round two. They do it by 5 points. Traralgon 10.874, Moe 10.969. That's scored on the Harvey Norman Computers Gippsland scoreboard. Our player of the day, thanks to Harvey Norman. Thanks for coming to that round. I'm going to feed over to our man. I'm going to go to the next one.
Thank you.